What is up, monkey friends of Dominion? This is Mishko for Monkey Factory Gaming. In today's video, we want to continue our strategy series about ADA, Aurora, Dante and Arachne we started shortly ago. In the last video, I showed you a detailed introduction about the mechanics synergy and how you could build ADA lineups. For all that haven't watched that series, I linked it in the right corner upside. Today's topic is countering ADA. So, do you maybe have the following questions? Do you have problems with ADA setups? How you could crush Aurora, Dante and Arachne lines in future? You don't know which type of heroes you should use in which situation, or you need a general game plan and strategy against these lineups? Then I'm really happy to show you now an approach to solve these issues. You will see different hero and mechanical counters with their skills and effects, plus I will give you a general game plan against ADA setups. After this, you get some great action fights, how ADA setups will be crushed on endgame levels with teams around 500k. So let's start. How I define a hero counter. As we know, all heroes have 4 different skills, and how these skill sets are designed, it affects abilities and stats of other heroes in a positive or negative way. This could be a buff that adds or increases different stats, or maybe an ability that counters an enemy skill set. The action has a direct impact on your friends or enemies around you. If I talk about mechanical counters, then I mean lineups, heroes and synergies that break holes in the enemy gameplay. We maybe interrupt or change their damage circles and try to outplay their strength and find their weak points. This comes to our game plan. For ADA, the core of heroes is in general a slowly consistent building damage lineup, which try to knock back the enemy in the corner and then control it by multiple stuns. Approaches are now to run lineups that build up damage for a specific point to shoot out heavy waves of damage, push them back so that we not get controlled in the corner, or find a way to survive in the corner and make our game. Let's continue with our counter heroes. Rufus could be a great choice as tank against magical based ADA setups. With his ultimate, he casts a shield that absorbs really high amounts of magical damage, plus he can't be killed by magic or pure damage. He then restores his health when he typically die. Corvus could be a nice option as tank or off tank. When his ulti is up, he counters Arachne really hard. Her violet skill adds small damage ticks over time, which deals pure damage. This Corvus throw back unfiltered to her and damage her a lot. He also brings a nice undead synergy when you pair him with Morrigan. She casts up to 6 little skeletons that could all become the target for different skills, for example Arachne's teleport or Dante's debuff and pushbacks, so these skills are totally wasted. If you also kill an enemy, a skeleton will spawn at this position and ideally turn Dante around. If this happens, you could avoid that Dante pushes your team back in the corner and so you outplay the whole mechanic of the ADA setup. Doran is a perfect choice as healer. His aura makes sure that nearly heroes regain health for their damage attacks. Normally this aura arrives heroes in positions 3 to 5. For the reason you are grouped in the corner, he makes sure that your whole team receives the aura and so could survive and strikes back. Faces is nice for 2 main reasons. First, he adds with his violet skill magic defense to your whole team and makes the enemy more ineffective. And second, with his strong skill power throw, he pushes back the next enemy and let him fall in the middle of the team, also stunning them for 3 seconds. This gives your team the necessary time to plan their attacks. Now we come to some damage dealers that could really hard fight back. We start with Satori. He builds with every hit or any skill that gains bonus energy fox marks on the enemy. You see this mark circling over the hero's heads. When he then ultimates, he throws out a heavy wave of damage which is really hard to survive for all heroes. When you face lineups including Jorgen, he could be very effective. He's slowly building these marks, so you have to make sure that he survives long enough. Pairings with Dorian and his aura or Astaroth that gives him the chance of a revival are great options. Kark is the next one. He deals crazy amounts of damage when he casts his blue skill. All enemies that are whipped by him or his friends in the air before receive double damage. With this, he could kill a whole team in seconds. He's low in health and mostly starts in second position, so he often becomes a target by executes or is shortly in first position through knockbacks. This makes him ulting really fast, so the fight could be really short before you get pinned in the corner. Same as for Satori, make sure that he survives long enough and avoid teams with Envari. The last great synergy I want to show you are the twins with Krista and Lars. This team is building heavy damage waves in combination. Krista casts her spikes under the enemy team, and when then Lars is ulting with his tornado, he pulls the whole team over the spikes, dealing heavy amounts of damage. Even the team could survive this first wave, they got pushed back and have to start the circle from new while your team is preparing the second wave. Some last words for some heroes you should also consider. As the Warrior with his ability to give a revival to a friend, Aurora that absorbs high amounts of magical damage has a stun and throwback magic damage. Jorgen to stop the energy game of the enemy and cast a shield that blocks magic damage. King Mao that pushes back the enemy and gives us some time. Darkstar that disables buffs, knockbacks and forces an enemy to fight by her side. Or Seer that silences magical teams and adds magical defense. Enough words, guys, now let's get into the action. I hope you like this video and subscribe to my channel for future movies and give me a feedback in the comment section. And always think about it, keep calm and eat a banana. Do what the do a shooby dooby do a do what the do a shooby dooby do a.
Take a seat, you cannot stand it. All I know, the flow harder than a Scotch bunny. Don't try studying me, you cannot manage. This ain't what you want, bitch, I'm a fucking phenomenon. What you want, bitch, I'm a fucking phenomenon. Say what you want, bitch, I'm a fucking phenomenon.
Yeah, you better listen, I'm bringing heat, you'll be a fan when I start rapping, way I'll have your fucking head spinning. I'm known as spit vicious, release bombs and go tick tick, boom, you blow me that head missing. I'm a phenomenon, stacking cheese like it's Parmesan, eight different flows, call me Octomom. I'm moving fast like the Autobahn, and I'm independent, so I'm not your fucking starving like it's Ramadan. Sick, twisted, gifted, can't copy, printed, can't hold me down, I shapeshift, I'm liquid, I took this beat, I might get convicted, they know how I move, it was predicted, persistent. Get into existence, so consistent, no assistance. Hear me once, become addicted. If I rap it, then I live it. There's no cap when I be breaking this.
This ain't what you want, bitch, I'm a fucking phenomenon. What you want, bitch, I'm a fucking phenomenon.
Into the light now. me, they watching me.
Section at 12, gon' find your ass way in New Orleans. Watch out a little bit, I'm jugging. Dissect your hand if your hand am I putting. Put two in your man if your man keep a looking. Act like a pussy, your panties get tooken. I'm not the type to go fuck with them niggas who fuck with them niggas who stay on some fuck shit. Youngin' trapping out the bando. From the ceiling fan to the damn floor, tryna stack my money up. Cause that's the only way we can go. Tell my mama that I'm okay. See the money coming through the doorway. Got a bad bitch with a lot of money, that's foreplay. Okay, yeah. They watching me, they watching me, they watching me.